welcome back to my channel. In this tutorial, we'll be discussing about distance joint 2D. A distance joint 2D maintains a fixed distance between two game objects that are controlled by rigid body physics. In order to understand this, let's take up the example. In this example, I have a wooden plank that has a rigid body 2D and a box glider attached to it. I'll add a component, name is distance joint 2D. Now it adds a green line onto the game object. Now one end of the line is connected to the game object and the other end is connected to a point in space. So if I don't want this game object to be attached to anything else, I just leave the connected rigid body slot empty. If I run this game, you will see the wooden plank oscillating around a fixed point in the world space. Now I want that this wooden plank attaches to any other game object and oscillates around that point or maintains a fixed distance between that point. So the way to do this is I'll just duplicate this plank, command D, and I'll name this to plank 2. I'll remove the distance joint component from it, separate it. Now in order to attach the first plank onto the second one, all I need to do is select the plank, go to the connected rigid body slot, drag and drop the plank 2 over there. So there you go, both the game objects now are connected to each other. Their pivot points also are perfectly set, you don't have to do anything else. If in case you need to change the pivot point, then all you need to do change is connected anchor property. So you can change the X value or the Y value. Now if I run this game, you will see the first plank maintaining a distance with the second plank and oscillating around it. So this is how you attach a game object to another game object using a distance joint. The next property that we have on the distance joint 2D is the auto configure distance. When the auto configure distance property is ticked, both these game objects will automatically be at a certain distance apart from each other. So if I have set the distance value to 3 here and I have the auto configure distance checked, then it will always maintain a distance of that units. These two game objects will never be at a distance less than the one specified in the distance property. So in order to illustrate this, I'll change the plank 2's properties a little bit. I'll change it to dynamic. I'll change the gravity scale to a negative 0.1. I switch the game view below. And scene view to the top. I'll change the plank's properties gravity scale to 0. You will see that when I run this game, both these game objects will always maintain that fixed distance between each other. They will never get closer than the specified distance value. But what if I don't mind about them getting a little close to each other? I don't want this rule to be strictly set to 3. So in this case, what I can do is I can tick on the max distance only property. What the max distance only property does is it will allow for the distance to get a little less than what you specified in the distance property, but it will not allow the distance to exceed the specified property. So if it's okay for you that they get a little close to each other, or by chance they have to come close to each other, then it will allow them to do so when the max distance only property is checked. Let's run this. Keep a look here. They are getting close and it's allowing them to come close. Once again, I'll run it. Check this line. See, it's getting away and then they are getting close and then going away. So this is about the distance and the max distance. I'll change the plank's properties gravity scale to 1 and the body type of the plank to be kinematic. Now here I'll change the first plank's position a little bit and run this game. So here, because the max distance only property is ticked, it comes close to the second plank, then goes down and goes to the other end. But there is no collision with this plank. So in order for these two to collide with each other, you'll have to change a property on the distance joint 2D component, that is the enable collision property. You'll have to tick it. Now when you run this game, you'll see that both these planks collide with each other. So that is what the enable collision property does. I'll change back the position to a bit right. The last property attached to the distance giant 2D component is the break force property. So what this break force property does is, currently its value is infinity. It means that no matter how much force is applied onto this plank, it will never snap off from its attached game object. But what if I want that when you apply a certain amount of force on this object, it snaps off and falls down. So in order to set that, you can set this property, that is break force. In my case, I'll just make it to around 10. Whenever there is a force that is greater than 10 that is applied on this plank, it will snap off from the attached rigid body. Let's run it. So you can see that the plank has snapped off from the attached rigid body. Why does this happen? This happens because the gravitational force that is applied onto the plank is greater than the value of the break force component that you have set. So I hope you understood about the distance joint 2D.
Make sure to hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon so you get notified of the new video that I post here on YouTube. Thank you for watching.